Hey everybody, it's Active Tech Review, it's Ryan here, and I'm actually doing a little quick video because, I'm doing a long video because I'm going to test different focus modes. Someone requested that I test different focus modes because they're curious to know what the difference is. I know one of the biggest things with these cameras is that you're always worried about autofocus, and here's the reality. Autofocus is expensive as shit, so remember that. So if you really want a good autofocus and you want a 1-inch sensor, just get the Mark V. Shell out the $1,100 bucks, you know, $1,100 after taxes or whatever, and just pay for it. But if you're curious to know, still know more about this camera and how well it focuses, currently right now I have it on face detection mode. And on face detection mode, it seems to be in pretty good focus. I'm at 3.2 aperture as I walk around here in front of my house. You know, I guess when it gets darker, it's not going to focus well. I mean, if I put it at 1.4, just imagine kind of like what the focus is going to be. Sorry for all the wind noise. But let's go ahead and look at this little tree here. And we'll kind of zoom in. Let's go ahead and go to 1.4. I don't know how it's going to be in this bright light. And I have it on, I'm going to put it on, let's go see here. I'm going to put on 49, area 49. So I'm going to just get really close. Let's go see if it focuses. And see how it's having trouble focusing. You know, it's on a 49 area. I don't know if that's like good or bad, but if I tap the screen though, it should focus. And look at that, it's failing. That already makes you not want to buy the camera, right? It's disappointing, right? Okay, let's do this. Let's go change the focus mode to one area, right? So we're on one area now. Well, this thing is moving. It just can't figure out. It's just probably too much movement. That is probably a failure, and I do apologize. But let's go see if we can do some other cool stuff. Let's go find something that doesn't move so much. I know, my side of my house over here. Oh man, there's mud. Got my Vibrams on. So we're looking at this thing, right? This doesn't move. Right, and we're putting on 49 area, right? Come on, smart camera. Look at that, it can't figure it out. And you know why it can't figure it out? Because it's at 1.4. There you go. See how slow that focus was? Because it's at 1.4 right now, right? It doesn't know what it's going to do. Okay, so let's go ahead and put it on... we'll put on 49 area, which is the focus mode. And then we're going to increase the aperture to 5.6. Then we'll go see how well this focus is. Focus, focus. It looks like it's having still a little bit tough time focusing. But you're going to have to... What do you expect, guys? You just want the perfect camera. I know I do. I want the perfect camera, but I don't want to spend $1,000 on a Mark V. There you go, got focus. Let's go back up. Is it in focus? Okay, let's get really close. Boom, out of focus. See, that focused pretty fast, I thought. Let's go back. Go forward. See, that focused pretty fast because it's at 5.6. Now, if I put on 1.4, watch this. I bet you it's going to take a while. Because remember, the focus point's so narrow now. So right here, I'm at 1.4. Boom! Look at that. Can't find you. Come on. I'm going to sit here all day. There you go. See, it's just because the aperture is so narrow. So if I put on, it's bright out here, I'll put on 9.0 aperture, right? And it's gonna be generally a sharper image in already most of the big section in focus. If I could go in really close, it's out of focus, it finds focus. If I come back, there you go. And then coming in, boom. And then it finds focus. And there's my wife, because we're supposed to go to lunch. And I'm taking forever here. But I'm sure, you know, you guys, you nerds out there like me, camera nerds, can appreciate this kind of a test. But I'm at, I don't know. So this is 49 point. That's what this is. I don't know, I do want the Mark V. I'm not going to lie, I kind of want to get a Mark V. And why do I want a Mark V? I just do. Why is there like a yellow spot in my phone? My camera. So right now, there's like a little weird spot. And you know what that little pink spot is? Like a pink spot like right here. You know what that is? That's lens flare, I think. So if I come in, it goes away. So there's a lens flare problem. You know, look at that. I'm selling this camera already. Not gonna get my Amazon commission. It's okay. I'm just goofing off with this camera. Why is it all? I hope that's not like some magnet problem.
Maybe it is. I don't know.
You know how old back in the day? Well, it's not. It can't be a magnet problem. It's only for CRTs. Where you put a magnet next to a TV and it would mess up the TV.
Yeah.
And I was afraid that's what happened to this. So I'm just. So right now I have it on. Tracking now, okay? So I'm on tracking. Let me go lower the aperture. Let's see here. I'm gonna lower the aperture to, let's do 2.8, all right?
Take it.
And right now it's not locked. So if I click tap on my face, now it's gonna track my, it looks like it's tracking my, this eye right here. If I go really far back, in a moving car, it's gonna focus. Tap it in, getting close. I don't know. Okay, let's go switch modes.
I have to say.
Wait a minute, 1 second. Okay, so right now, vlogging, I'm on 1 point area of focus. So if I put my hand here, I would imagine it's gonna focus because that's where the area is to focus. Or maybe it won't. This camera is another failure. It looks like I'm pointing the middle finger at you. Okay, so if I do the screen, I can, I don't know. I wish I could help you make a decision on buying a camera. I know you're probably thinking this camera sucks. I don't know, what can you expect? You know, it's a vlogging camera.
Okay. Did you just buy that camera?
I did. Okay. Focus. There you go, look, I'm in focus. See, it took a while. Then I go back. Okay, now I'm gonna go really close. Boom! Focus. I do have stabilization on, in case you're curious. Okay, now I'm at 2.8 with 2.8 aperture, autofocus mode. So, I'm gonna go far away. There's my wife right there. Then I'm gonna get close, out of focus. See, that focused pretty fast, right? And I'm gonna go look at my shifter thingy. See that shifter right there? Get really close. See, that focus pretty good, right? I know it's kind of weird. Right here, right there. Focus. Looking focused. Focus well enough. The problem is, when you have it at 1.4, it's going to be slow. See, it's slow here. See, you can't figure out what it is. Man, look at that, it's not working. There you go, look at that. I'm getting in focus now. It's able to figure it out. You can find, actually, you know what? I press the touch the screen. There you go. See, when you touch the screen, what happens is it disables autofocus. Like, I'll tap the screen now, or I'll tap something on the screen. Autofocus is disabled, it shouldn't focus. Because I tap the screen, which disables autofocus. But now I'll tap my face, and now I become focused. Okay, so let's do this instead. How about we put autofocus on? I'm gonna put it at 1.4, right? Make it look terrible, or make the autofocus work really bad. And I'm gonna just go over here to my Prius car. So see, has this passenger right there? I'm gonna go in really close. Boom. Oh, that focused pretty quick. I don't understand how this is supposed to work. Oh, probably because it's black, white text against a black background. Boom, right there. So you can see how that's focused. So you can see the depth of field in this. Track, seek, get back, out of focus, focus. Coming close. I don't know, that's focused heck of fast. I don't understand this thing. Okay, here.
I think it's colorblind.
I don't understand this. See, now it's having trouble, right? But that was actually pretty decent, you know, that was actually pretty decent, I have to say. Right now, you know what it looks like? It looks like face detection. It seems to be a much more better tool for autofocus versus these other modes, which is tracking, 49 area, custom multi, and one area. I mean, custom multi is probably something you can adjust if you want. I haven't really messed with it. You know, I'm more of like a run, gun, shoot, vlog, take pictures of my family. Custom multi. So it looks like for the most part, if you're going to use this camera, you're going to use face detection. And then if you're vlogging, that's fine. So autofocus seems to be working all right.
Freedom!
Yes,
it's just like once a week, you know, you get there.
You might be wondering why we're all excited, because we are parents. We have three children. One of those kids is two, the youngest one, and we just put her in daycare. 10 hours without a child, 2-year-old. We can get to work. It is amazing. It's sort of cliche to be stereotypical Asians. We get to work!
We get to
work. Yes!
It's tax time!
It's like that TV show. I like working though, I do. I mean, it's cool that we do both run our own businesses, right? It's kind of neat. Different. I do work for a company, but you know, it's kind of a business within a business. Let's go take a look at this. Check another focus mode. Oh, look at this. Focus. Out of focus. Out of focus. And focus. I don't know. It focuses good enough. You know, the problem is, see, like right here is going to have trouble maybe because there's bright light coming from this side. One thing you're going to probably, what's going to happen is if there's like lots of white or like a lot of not enough contrast. Because, I mean, I think it is a contrast-based system. Right, so if you have weird contrasting lights, it's not gonna work as well, I would imagine. You wanna say anything, babe?
Anything, babe.
Okay, so the one thing that I think is important about autofocus on cameras, because I know autofocus is a big deal, because I want the perfect autofocus just like you. It's just understanding the limitations of the autofocus and understanding how it behaves. Because if you understand how it behaves, you can use your camera better, right? Going all the way, I'm at 1.4 right now, by the way. But see, like with this camera, like if I touch the screen, I'll disable autofocus, and I'll bring it in close, it's not going to focus. Oh, actually, it did focus. See, I don't understand how this works. Well, I guess it's face detection. I think that's what it is. So if I have it on multi, let's go test multi real quick. So if I put it on multi, okay, here. So I'm going to put on multi-area function, which is a 49 area, right? And I have it far away, so try to focus. And I'm going to tap the screen, which disables autofocus. So if I get close, it shouldn't focus. Right. So it looks like when you're in... see, it focus. I don't understand. Is this AF off? Oh, I can turn off AF. So AF is off now, I think. No, it's autofocusing still. I wish I could understand this camera. Maybe if you're watching this video, you can explain it to me.
It's crazy.
You explain something, what's going on. And this is so close to the camera. AF off. I don't understand this thing. Why is it doing it? So I go back over here. Is autofocus off now? No, it's not off. I don't focus as well enough. It's probably not as good as the RX Mark V. And if you're thinking about getting a Mark V, see, I'm thinking about getting a Mark V. I'm thinking about just returning this and getting a Mark V. But I like the touchscreen so much. I really do. The touchscreen is more of a usability. And really, if apples to apples, the main thing is $300. That's $300 difference in price. You know, $697 versus $949 or whatever. Why can't you just be a touchscreen Sony? I have it at 1.4 and I'm outside. I would imagine that there would be some overexposure, but it seems to figure itself out. I don't understand. Anyways. I'm going to be going to eat some sushi, and we're going to be able to take a look and see how... It'll have a little bit lower light conditions and see how the autofocus functions in low light. But I'm really dark. Why am I dark? Because there's such a big bright behind me, see? Alright, I'm at 1.4 right now. Oh, thank you very much. And we are looking at some sushi here. Look at that. That looks good. Back out. I think focus is well enough. Let me increase the aperture to 4.0. Okay, I'm going to change it out and put it in out of expressive mode and back to the normal mode. So this is normal mode. If you notice a big difference in the color setting, it's actually not quite as rich and colorful. Everything looks a little bit more dull, maybe the color. It's actually more accurate color. You know, take a picture of me. that's actually a more accurate color. I'm at 4.0 right now. Let's go to, I'm on face detection mode. Let's go ahead and let's go to 9.0. I would imagine there's a lot of noise at 9.0 because it's not as bright in here. I'm at 8.0. Far, coming in close. And I'm gonna go to 1.4. 1.4. So right now I have it in auto mode, and we have a sushi here with a little bit too much wasabi. My wife thinks I can't handle it. So let's go see how well this goes. So picky.
I'm only getting one. You might as well just get the one with the less, with the least amount of twigs.
I'm at 2.0 right now. Boom! Look at that. Out of focus. In focus. Right now, I have it on face detection mode. Right now, here, face detection mode. iPhone right there. It's focusing pretty good. Now there's a bright light behind me, so see, it's gonna probably have a tough time to focus.
You know you're ruining my show, like you're moving your hands.
I know you're taking a picture. Alright, so I'm gonna end this autofocus test with just a few series of quick tests. This is 49 point. This is setting an area, it's called area 49 point, I guess, a bunch of squares. So that way you can kind of see my face. I'm talking to you, I'm bring the camera far away from me. I'm at 2.8 aperture. Boom, look at this. And let's go see if the autofocus works. It's kind of hard not to touch the screen when you have it in selfie mode, because again, on 49 point mode, what happens is the moment we touch the screen, it sort of disables autofocus. But I mean, it seems to focus pretty fast. I mean, considering the lighting situation here, I don't know what the I haven't really gone through the instructions. I'm just kind of messing around making this video and see how fast it focuses. Focus. I mean, it seems to focus pretty good. See, look at this here. So I think that's the thing, you just don't know when the autofocus is gonna work. It, for the most part, it seems to work pretty good all most of the time, but there are certain conditions, I don't know what they are. I guess it's just learning what those conditions are, when the autofocus isn't as good. So I'm gonna go ahead and switch it to, let's try tracking. So I guess tracking makes it so that it follows me, so as I change this, it's gonna automatically, I guess it's really meant for like if an object is moving. I don't know. Anyways, that's the end of this focus test. If you felt like this was good enough for you to understand kind of how the autofocus works on this camera, let me know, or maybe another test I could try. All right, bye. So I'm continuing this autofocus test vlogging. This looks terrible because I have the aperture at 5.6 and it's dark outside, so let's turn it up. And I want to see how this does in low light. So we'll see how this works out. I'm just curious. And you'll get an idea of how, you know, just understand it's not gonna be perfect, man.
She's gonna fool this girl.
It's okay, she has to learn. This is how you learn. This is a tough love. It's not even that tough.
You can do it. Oh, yeah, good job.
Hey, look at this. When I was a kid, no one congratulated me for freaking closing the door. This is bullshit.
Ryan.
What? It is. It's bull crap.
You, You don't swear.
It's bull caca. That's what it is. Hey, look, you like my new earrings?
How is it?
Are they cute?
It looks like you broke your headphones.
Yeah, exactly.
It's so weird.
Put your seatbelt on.
They're not even attached.
Essentially, you're in the car. Are you in the car, Julian?
Yeah.
Okay. I saw your camera. You have a, which camera do you have?
Oh, it's a Canon.
All right, so continuing to vlog out in the night, 1.4 aperture, because I like testing stuff like this. Behind me, I got my babies. Look at this. I'm staying in focus. Look at this. Going close, going far. Going close. Am I gonna focus? See, it's focusing pretty fast. Maybe because there's good contrast. I'll put this camera on top of my car. Hopefully it doesn't fall. All right.
Here you go.
Okay. So it seems to be doing all right. See, I am doing 1080 here. I'm not doing no 4K. I don't think it makes a difference. Okay, do you have the keys, babe?
What?
Do you have the keys?
What?
Do you have the keys? All right, so we are walking. Let's focus. See, the 1.4 I really like because it just gives you so much flexibility with low light stuff. I mean, on the screen, it just looks so good. There's my baby.
He keeps on saying that he's like,
I'm taking with the iPad if you don't eat dinner. Give me the iPad now. Go first, yeah. Because our orders are complicated. Look at that, it's lettuce. It's focus, out of focus, in focus. Okay, baby, is she in focus? She is in focus. Am I in focus? Okay, it's having trouble. Oh no, there, I'm in focus now. It seems to be doing, whoa.
Uh-oh.
Kids.
Kids,
what's that?
The E.
Eat? You want to eat rice? She wants rice, babe. I wish I understood this better.
What?
Okay, so we are here in Chipotle getting a burrito. And there's my baby. Say hi.
Yeah.
What the heck? Oh, she's cranky. She's focusing on her face pretty good. What are you guys watching?
Uh-huh.
What? Daddy
wants a spoon. Oh, I
don't get any more. That took a while. Sick kids. I don't know. The autofocus on here is pretty decent. I think it's pretty decent. I like the autofocus on this. Hey, it's not a... I still want a Mark V though. I'm probably gonna get it eventually. I'll probably get the Mark VI when it comes out. I'll probably be called the RX 5000.
Oh. Did you take a nap at school today?
I'm gonna go to Applebee's.
Oh wow.
So that time the autofocus was slow.